Hello everyone, my name is Egan, welcome back to another trailer review. The X-Men Apocalypse official trailer has been released as of recording yesterday. And this is a big one. This is 2 minutes and 29 seconds, so they're going to show a lot. And I do hope they will show a lot. I think they will show a lot of Apocalypse, which is the main villain of the movie. And I'm pretty sure that they will show the Four Horsemen. And the Four Horsemen are the followers of Apocalypse. It's the same as in the biblical sense. I think it was war, plague, death, and something. And it's going to be, of course, it's going to be mutant, but I don't know if they're going to do it like in the anime series, the real Four Horsemen, or are they going to do it in like in the comics and choose some random mutants, because a lot of mutants have been in the Four Horsemen. For example, Wolverine was once one of the Four Horsemen of Apocalypse. I'm not gonna guess anything. I'm just gonna watch the trailer. I haven't watched the trailer yet. If you're new to my trailer reviews, I pause a lot, I rewind a lot, but I do play the whole trailer just to get every detail out. So let's watch. Okay, this is apparently the X-Men school, and it looks pretty cool. Oh. You can clearly see this is the suit is typical 80s fashion, and you can see that Professor Xavier has long hair, deliberately done, because I believe at the end of the movie they're going to shave his head off, which was already stated in the previous movie. But this movie is definitely playing in the 80s, so they're leaving the 70s, so years have passed since the last movie. Okay, I don't know. As you can see, the children are now outside, and one of the children right here is wiping some off, and she's sad. So I'm guessing that the school of gifted children is being under attack. And Jennifer Lawrence, aka Mystique, is watching how it's done? I don't know. Oh, who do we see there? We see Scott Summers, aka Cyclops, and we see the Nightcrawler in a fucking Michael Jackson jacket. What the fuck? He's wearing a Michael Jackson, which is typical in an era because everyone had a Michael Jackson jacket. Okay, Jean Grey, nothing. Oh, this is where they have class. Weird that it's not the typical classroom. Okay. Oh. Oh, they're going to show the history of Apocalypse, apparently, because I'm guessing this is... I'm guessing the first mutant, Apocalypse, which is normal tan, because in the comics he was gray, and that is the celestial suit that they give. This is the Apocalypse, and this is the celestial suit that's been given to Apocalypse. They say that Apocalypse is the first mutant. I say it's the longest living mutant, because I don't know. They always say, oh, this is the first mutant, but then 50 comic books later, oh, no, Apocalypse wasn't the first mutant, this was the first mutant. And then again, 50 comic books later, oh, this wasn't the first mutant, this is the first mutant. So I'm saying that he's not the first mutant, I'm saying he's the longest living mutant. So far, of my knowledge. Doesn't matter. Oh, yeah. Oh, that is a strange look on him. Huh. Okay. Oh, that is awesome. So it's like a tomb that is coming up. I'm guessing it's going to go to that person and is going to drop down and he's going to assimilate the celestial suit. Who knows? But I approve of this. I approve of this. They should tell the history of Apocalypse. It's not something like what the Avengers are doing with, oh, here's Thanos. Where did he come from? No, fuck it, here's Thanos. But who is he? Fuck it, here's Thanos. Yeah, but what can he do? Fuck it, here's Thanos. No, I like this that they actually explain who Apocalypse is and where he came from. Because there are different types of stories where Apocalypse came from. Apocalypse, for the newbies here, he can change, he can control every molecule in his body, which is an awesome, awesome power. He can grow big, he can do everything, and I believe he can also control every other molecules that are around him. I'm not sure though, I forgot. Oh, I'm guessing that is Storm.
You are all my children.
I'm guessing that is Storm. So four horsemen is going to be Storm. I believe. I don't quote me on it. I read somewhere that it's going to be Storm, Psylocke, and the Archangel. I don't know the fourth one yet. I couldn't find it anywhere. That information. Ooh, Cerebro. Okay. Oh! Yeah, we already saw Shadow Watch. We already saw how Thanos looks like, but this is really intimidating. A very awesome look on him. But what is he wearing? Where is he? Oh! Magneto. Why is he here? Is he going to... Oh, you know what's going on? Magneto fought the president in the last movie, and because he lost, he's probably now in hiding, and he's working as a normal human. He's trying to be a normal human being between these, I'm guessing. And it means... Oh, who is she? Who is she? Is this Psylocke? I don't know. Oh, whenever Apocalypse's eyes turn white, means that he's using his powers. Will Magneto be the first horseman? Holy fucking hell shit! He's using his powers and everyone just dropped down. That is a fucking awesome power. We see Storm here, and I'm guessing this is Psylocke. So, oh my god, is Magneto going to be... Oh, yes. This is where Magneto gets his helmet, and this helmet is actually, I don't know if it's going to be explained here, but it's actually so that Charles Xavier couldn't get in his mind, which is actually also been explained in the X-Men first comic books, in the X-Men beginning or something, where doesn't matter. This is, but he gets it from, he gets it from Apocalypse. But I also noticed this look is either he's obviously scared actually of Apocalypse, or he resents him. But this is definitely a look that doesn't belong to someone who serves as a fourth horseman. Ooh, Archangel costume is looking awesome. Ooh, all metally and shit. If you remember, Archangel, his wings were just normal. Just normal, you know, angel wings. And this is all metally, which is appropriate because the Four Horsemen needs to have fucking weapons. And I believe he can shoot those wings, those feathers, he can shoot them and everyone can die. You know? Pew, 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 pew. That is the new sound effect that they should use. You know, whenever Archangel attacks, pew, 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 pew. Whenever Black Widow attacks, pew, 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 pew. And she has to do the voice with her mouth. Pew, pew, pew. That will be awesome. Psylocke is behind him she has two swords. One sword is actually some kind of laser. She doesn't cut it, but she can it's a different kind of sword. When she goes like this through your head, your brain explodes. Not your head, your fucking brain explodes.
Like Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse.
Okay, oh, the storm looks awesome.
Horsemen of the Apocalypse.
And I'm guessing this is where she gets her white hair. Wow, the costume looks awesome. Look at all, you see all of this, these are all destructions. So I'm guessing that there's actually an apocalypse is going to happen. So that means that not America, but I'm guessing the whole world is going to be under attack. Or I'm sorry, what I'm saying is not Washington or not only New York, but the whole America and probably the whole world is going to be under attack by apocalypse. And a Magneto is awesome. Look at this. There's, oh my god, this looks like Detroit actually. A normal day in Detroit. I'm sorry, people in Detroit, don't get me. Oh, this is in Egypt. This is definitely in Egypt because we have some pyramids here. And we have the Archangel Magneto without his helmet. We have Psylocke with the katana sword. That's awesome. And we have Storm. Storm is just, I don't care. I'll just fucking sit here. Oh fuck, I think Apocalypse is going to attack Egypt. Oh, this is definitely Egypt. Because I don't think that, yeah, these are old cars. And these things you don't see in America. So this is definitely in Egypt. Woo! Look at it. He's absorbing every molecule, every atom of everything here. Oh, that's so freaking amazing. Oh, did you see that? Tornadoes? Oh, look at those tornadoes. I wonder if there's sharks in them. Okay, that was a lame joke. Let's move on.
Take everything from them.
Wait, that line didn't make sense. This is like he's gonna go against Apocalypse. Like he's going to fight Apocalypse. Maybe he's going to betray him. This Memorial Day.
He needs to.
Ooh, okay. This is definitely the school is being under attack. We have Hank McCoy. We have Quicksilver. We have all the children outside. We have Jennifer Lawrence right here. So definitely the school of gifted children is going to be under attack. Okay, and they're escaping. Oh, the suburbs, though, definitely the fucking whole America will be under attack.
Of people killed.
Oh, the crappity ass. You see, I knew that America had missiles everywhere.
Of people killed.
Oh, look at that. Everywhere, every acre, there's a missile coming out of. Oh, this is so scary. Holy crap. Mystique. I've always been against Jennifer Lawrence being Mystique, and it's because, and if you remember the first two movies, she had those cheeks that were like coming out 10 meters from her face. But this time it looks like she gained weight and now it looks good. But it was like, yes, my name is Mystique. Yes, but now it looks good. The best Mystique I've seen so far was in the first X-Men movie. That was an awesome Mystique. The first and second movie of X-Men they did, she was brilliant and she was fucking hot. Oh damn, she was fucking hot. Oh, the time is moving slow, so I'm guessing this is something to do with Quicksilver. But this is definitely the school of gifted children. The school, I don't remember the name, but everything is exploding. So that means that definitely the school is under attack. Oh, what does it say? I'm trying to read what this says. It looks like it's reversed. This is an L. But shouldn't the L be like this? Why is it like this? This image is reversed.
Leads the X-Men.
Oh, the Black Wing.
Leads the X-Men.
I don't know if you saw it. Oh, crap. Oh, Million Dollar Man.
The X-Men.
Oh, the X-Wing does look. Ah, it doesn't have long wings though, like a Black Wing should have. But, yeah. I'm okay with it. I'm just their play. This is awesome. This is definitely look, Mrs. Pac-Man, Million Dollar Man. This definitely looks like the 80s.
You're gonna join them, aren't you?
Who is she? Oh, this is his mother. Oh, in the previous X-Men, Quicksilver's mom didn't have much of a role in the movie. But the first time you saw it, you could tell that, she knew that her son had some powers. Two, she knew that her son was doing bad things. And three, she was also worried about her son. Because Magneto, Professor Xavier, and Wolverine walked in the door and she was like, what did he do again? Or what did he steal again? Or something like that. Oh, this is so... Oh my god, he's wearing leather pants. He's wearing leather pants. Oh, that must itch. That must itch.
Want to make it out of the house more, right?
Oh, and I'm guessing that... Because they show Jennifer Lawrence a lot and that she's now walking in front of them, that she's going to be the... Oh, maybe they're going to do a new team of X-Men where Jennifer Lawrence is the team leader. We see Cyclops, Quicksilver. I think this is Nightcrawler. And we have Jean Grey.
It's all of us.
Oh, and we have Hank McCoy. So that is definitely... The behind Scott is Hank McCoy, the Beast, in his full form as the Beast.
It's all
of us. Awesome. Oh, what?
It's all of us.
What? There was Professor Charles Xavier punching, but he doesn't normally punch someone. He uses his mind. I will take over your mind. Pew! But that means that this is either a dream sequence or he's desperate. Oh, this is awesome.
Against
the
god.
Oh, he's using power. Holy fucking shit ass. Wait a minute. Now that I think of it.
It's all of us.
He's standing. Professor Xavier is standing. And if I... Okay, we're at 1 minute 20. I have to rewind all the way back. If I remember correctly...
A feeling that someday they'll come for
he's,
you.
He's... This is more like...
A feeling that someday...
He's driving. So he's definitely in the wheelchair there. I'm guessing, okay, 1 minute 20 we were at. Here we are.
It's all of us.
So, this is definitely a dream sequence. But look at that, like I said, he can... Holy shit, this looks scary. He can manipulate every molecule in his body so he can grow bigger. That is awesome. Oh, this is... I think that this Mystique's costume. She looks hot, by the way, here. Yeah! A bridge is getting destroyed. Typically in an X-Men movie, another fucking bridge gets destroyed. It wouldn't be an X-Men without a bridge getting destroyed. Ooh, everything is in ruins. We do see Scott in his new costume, which is awesome. We see Beast down there. But I prefer Beast, actually. Well, if you remember the animated series, he only had a under roof. Let's call it like that. So I prefer in that costume. Oh, we see. Well, we saw this before, but if you look carefully at Quicksilver's face, he's worried. He's very worried. Holy crap. Is this Quicksilver? That means that when he runs, he has. Wow, he destroys everything. And by the way, this guy here is like a. Psh, okay, what the fuck? I'm just gonna stand here. Nobody touches me.
Forget everything you think you know.
Okay. Oh, the Nightcrawler! Yeah, Archangel started off as a cage fighter and Nightcrawler as a circus freak. So, I don't know. Oh, we see Psylocke in her awesome costume. Oh, look at that ass. Woo! He does it. Oh, we see Commander Stryker. Which all of you know is the main character against mutant resistance. I don't know. He's also the one that gave Wolverine Logan the adamantium. Holy crap! Oh, hey, the Black Boy has his wings. Oh, that is awesome! We also hear Jennifer Lawrence doing the speech.
He always had
oh crap, I did, sorry.
And
We hear Jennifer Lawrence doing the speech, which means that she's going to be the new team leader. Blackwing.
You're X-Men.
Yeah! Storm attacking, nothing. Oh. I used to think that the Cyclops was one of the weakest mutants out there. Like, it just shoots rays at the sides. But also, the animated series didn't do much justice. But trust me, Cyclops is one of the baddest motherfuckers out there. You think that he's shooting lights out of the screen? No, that is actually the energy of another dimension escaping through his fucking eyes. Behind those eyes, he has a whole fucking new dimension. Think about that. And he says brother, Havoc, Alex Storm, is also, he shoots from his belly. He shoots, not from his belly, but from his body. The race. Only the strong. Oh, this is awesome. I try not to pause a lot because the video is already getting too long. We see, this is an awesome scene. We'll survive. Oh, yeah, you see Archangel is shooting these things. Oh, that is Havoc. Oh my god, there was a... Huh. Why did they show Havoc until this moment? Not before. So this is Havoc. This is Hank McCoy. I believe this is, well, Jennifer Aris, Lawrence ass. And we see Professor Charles Xavier connected to Cerebro. And I think that he's mentally under attack. And I think... by Apocalypse, and we see Havoc destroying Cerebro. But if he destroys Cerebro while someone is connected, doesn't that mean that that person is going to die? Or, oh my god, don't quote me on this, but I think we might lose Havoc in this movie, because the whole trade didn't show him up until now, and we're already 2 minutes in. Holy crap, everything ruins. Oh, this is again. Everything gets sucked in by Apocalypse. But I don't think this is Egypt anymore. Yeah, this is Egypt because, and I have to stop. Here are some Arabian letters. Oh my God! No, don't kill Mystique. Mystique is one of my favorite X-Men. Well, my favorite mutants. Next to Rogue, of course, because they're both half fucking hot. That's it? That's it? Nothing else?
Everything they built!
That was an awesome scene. This is also an awesome scene. The best scene in the previous X-Men movie was, without a doubt, it was... belonged to Quicksilver, you know, when he put on headphones. If time, and he went all around and he shot everything. That was an awesome scene. I don't have a bad opinion about this movie, but I don't also have a good opinion. I'm a little bit mixed in. It's like, yeah, you make the movie, okay, we're gonna watch it. I think that this is not going to be an excellent movie. I don't think it's going to be a bad movie. It's going to be an okay movie. That's it. But we'll see. I'm actually excited, a little bit excited to watch this. Anyways, if you stuck around until this moment, you're fucking awesome. I'm gonna wrap it up right here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked the video, molest the like button. Don't forget to share and subscribe. Very, very important. And I will see you next time.